Hey there, Tony Polecastro here from Tony's Acoustic Challenge. One of the necessities on any guitar player's guitar journey is learning guitar licks. It's super fun. It's fun to have a little musical nugget to play. But one of the huge problems is that a guitar lick sometimes stays as a lick and we never actually integrate it into our playing, which is a huge bummer, and we're leaving a bunch of opportunity on the table. So in today's video, I'm not only going to teach you the most popular bluegrass lick, but I'm also going to teach you how to incorporate any lick into your guitar playing. In fact, I'm going to give you a framework at the end of the video that you're going to totally dig and be able to apply right away. But without further ado, let's learn the most popular lick in all of acoustic music, in all of bluegrass, and that is the G run, okay? The G run, you've probably heard it, you might not know what it's called, but it sounds exactly like this. It's a beautiful way to end a song. It's a beautiful way to punch the rhythm. Like if you're playing along to a rhythm and the verse ends, it's a great way to punch or kind of add an exclamation point like this. All right, so how do you play that lick? Well, I'm gonna teach it to you first. It's actually pretty darn easy. I'm gonna go through the fretting positions first. So we'll understand what happens on the fretting hand. And then I'm gonna teach you the pick direction. And then I'll get to that framework for adding any lick to your playing. So here we go. So the fretting for this particular G run, for the G run, is we're gonna make a G chord, okay? So your pinky and ring finger will be on the third fret of the high E and B string, respectively. Your middle finger will reach up to the third fret of the low E, index finger the second fret of the A. Nice big G chord. In fact, we're gonna play the lick out of this position and you'll see why at the end of the video. So we're gonna start by hitting that third fret of the low E, the open A, the first fret of the A, their index finger, second fret of the A, their middle finger, open D, second fret of the D, their middle finger, open D again, and then a G. Open G string, okay? So it's low E third fret, open A, first fret of the A, second fret of the A, open D, second fret of the D, open G. All right? So the timing is a crucial thing here, and it's gonna sound a little weird, but that first note is a quarter note. Everything else are eighth notes, okay? So it's gonna go one, two, and three, and four, and one. I'll do that just a little bit slower so you can play along with me. One, two, and three, and four, and one. And then you can go ahead and strum a G chord if you want to at the end of it. Now, in terms of what you're gonna be doing with your picking hand, the lick is almost entirely alternate picking, meaning we trade off downstrokes and upstrokes, except there's a little bit of a funkiness at the beginning because it's a downstroke on that low E and then a down on the open A. Okay, and then it goes up, down, up, down, up, down. So if I was actually to play that with actual rhythm, with the real timing, I'm gonna go ahead and say the pick direction so you can kind of follow. So it's gonna sound like this with the pick direction. Down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Do it just a touch slower. Down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So there you have it. That is the bluegrass G run. It's an awesome lick. It's a lick that every acoustic guitar player needs to know. Whether you love bluegrass, well, if you love bluegrass, you need to know it. If you don't love bluegrass, you should still know this lick because chances are you're gonna hear it and you're gonna wanna play it. And I'll tell you what, it's really rewarding, especially when you incorporate it into your playing. Now, here's the framework that I wanna share with you that will allow you to incorporate any lick that you learn into your playing. And I like to refer to it as the LIP lick learning method. It's a mouthful, I know, but I like the idea of LIP and lick in the same sentence. I know it's a little corny, maybe even a little cheesy, but I guarantee you, you're never gonna forget this. Okay, so LIP, L-I-P. First, you have to learn the lick. Second, you have to identify the time window that the lick takes up. And third, you have to practice the lick in context. Okay, so learn, identify, and practice. Okay, we've already done the hard part. We've just learned the bluegrass G lick. Now we have to identify the time window. So the time window for this particular lick takes a full measure. And you can always check your lick out by testing the timing, by actually counting along with it. So in the case of this bluegrass lick, this bluegrass G run, it's gonna be a full measure. And you're gonna hear it go one, two, and three, and four, and one. Right, an entire measure. One, two, and three, and four, and one. This is absolutely crucial because if you know the time window of the lick, if you've identified that time window, you can then insert it into your playing, whether it be rhythm or a solo, whatever you're working on. So understanding that time window is absolutely crucial. So we've learned the lick, we've identified the time window, and now we have to practice the lick in context. Now, how do you do that? Well, first of all, you have to do it slowly. So what I'm gonna do to practice the bluegrass G run and to practice it in context is I'm gonna maintain a steady rhythm over a G chord, and then when I reach my one beat, I'm gonna go ahead and insert that lick for a measure and then go right back to my rhythm. Now I'm gonna count along with the rhythm and through the lick so you can understand how this all comes together. So I'm gonna start by just doing a boom chicka strum on a G chord, and that's gonna sound like this. One, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three. So I'm gonna maintain that rhythm, and then when I insert the lick, I'm gonna keep counting, okay? So you can understand where that lick comes in and how that time window kind of fits in with everything. So here goes nothing. One, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three, and four, and one, two, and three, four, and one, two, and three, and four, and one. So that's how I would want you to practice this lick, or really any lick, in context. Learn that lick, identify the timing window, and practice it in context. The lip method, you'll never forget it. As cheesy as it is, you'll never forget it, and it's gonna be super beneficial to your playing and growth as a guitar player. Now, I might not have mentioned this, but learning licks is one of the essential categories of guitar improvement, one of the five essential categories of guitar improvement. And in Tony's Acoustic Challenge, we rotate through those five essential categories of guitar improvement every single week. Warm-ups, licks, improvisation and scales, rhythm guitar, and chord transitions. Now, if you don't know anything about Tony's Acoustic Challenge and you're curious, please click the link in the video here or in the description to learn more. And if it resonates with you, if it's something that you want to do, if you want to take your guitar playing to the next level, I want you to request an invite today. You're going to have a ton of fun. You're going to be learning licks and how to incorporate them into your playing. So thanks so much for checking out the lesson, and I hope to see you over at Tony's Acoustic Challenge.